Hello and welcome to worship on Pentecost Sunday. It's a local arrangement, hence the fact that I'm here, and I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who's helped with this service. I hope you will enjoy seeing some familiar faces as we go through. So just our call to worship. Father, we come before you. We ask your help as we join together. Please fill us with your Spirit, that we might be your voices, eyes, hands, feet, and presence in the world. These are strange days. Things are relaxing, but we are still so far from normal, so far from any sense of what was. We often ask ourselves, When will we get back to normal, to the way things were before? I somehow think that simply returning to what was will not be possible. The experience of enforced confinement will inevitably change us, and there is no going back to what we were before or what life was like before. We must reflect on what we've learned, look at how we have lived differently, and what changes we need to make for the future.
A reflection by Sonia Renee Taylor. We will not go back to normal. Normal never was. Our pre-corona existence was not normal, other than we normalised greed, inequality, exhaustion, depletion, extraction, disconnection, confusion, rage, hoarding, hate, and lack. We should not long to return, my friends. We are being given an opportunity to stitch a new garment, one that fits all of humanity and nature. When eventually this crisis passes and we are tempted to go back to normal as quickly as possible, it will be time to stop and reflect on what was so unhealthy about our pre-corona existence. It will be time for us to stitch together a new garment, one that envelops us in a more thoughtful, compassionate, nurturing way of being, a way of being based on love for each other, our communities, and for all of creation.
Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do. Father, I place into your hands the things that I've been through. Father, I place into your hands the way that I should go, for I know I always can trust you. Father, I place into your hands my friends and family. Father, I place into your hands the things that trouble me. Father, I place into your hands the person I would be, for I know I always can trust you. Father, we love to see your face, we love to hear your voice. Father, we love to sing your praise and in your name rejoice. Father, we want to walk with you and in your presence rest, for we know we always can trust you. Father, I want to be with you and do the things you do. Father, I want to speak the words that you are speaking to. Father, I want to love the ones that you will draw to you, for I know that I am one with you.
God of all hope, we call on you today We pray for those who are living in fear. Fear of illness, fear for loved ones, fear for the future. May your spirit give us a sense of calmness and peace. We pray for your church in this time of uncertainty, for those people who are worried about worship and the future, for those who will feel more isolated by not being able to attend, for those needing to make decisions in order to care for others. Grant us your wisdom. Holy God, we remember that you have promised that nothing will separate us from your love, demonstrated to us in Jesus Christ. Help us turn our eyes, hearts and minds to you. Amen. I will now say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thine will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'm not want. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still waters. His goodness restores my soul, and I will trust in you alone. And I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me, your goodness will lead me on. He guides my ways in righteousness. He anoints my head with oil, and my cup it overflows with joy. I feast on his pure delight, and I will trust in you alone. And I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me, your goodness will lead me home. And though I walk the darkest path, I will not fear the evil one, for you are with me and your rod and staff are the comfort I need to know. And I will trust in you alone. I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me, your goodness will lead me home.
God is always with us, and through his Spirit we are commissioned to be there for each other, even in these difficult times, and maybe especially in these difficult times. I'm not a huge talking on the phone fan, though I still do it. But we have email, text, a shout over 2 metres, a card, a letter, leaving the shopping on a doorstep, Zoom, or just a smile, just get an eye contact with somebody. The list is long. The bonds are beautiful. Let us continue to build them.
Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, bind us together in love. There is only one God, there is only one King, there is only one body. That is why we sing. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, bind us together in love. Made for the glory of God, purchased by His precious Son. Born with the right to be free, Jesus the victory has won. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, bind us together in love. We are the family of God. We are His promise divine. We are His chosen desire. We are His glorious new wine. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, bind us together in love. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, bind us together in love.
A reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 1 to 13. If I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices when truth wins out. Love never gives up. Love never loses faith. It's always hopeful and endures through every circumstance. Prophecy and speaking in unknown languages and special knowledge will become useless, but love will last forever. Now, our knowledge is partial and incomplete. And even the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when full understanding comes, these partial things will become useless. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now we see things imperfectly, as in a cloudy mirror. But when we will see everything with perfect clarity. all that I know now is partial and incomplete. But then I will know everything completely, just as God knows me completely. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of all these is love.
Let us pray. God of grace, we turn to you in prayer in this difficult time, a time in which the spread of a pandemic infection has forced our governments to implement restrictive measures that limit the normal course of life, shutting us up in our increasingly small sphere, but they are necessary.
God of love, help us to maintain community bonds and solidarity with our sisters and brothers, especially with those who are in sickness and need, and help us to be a family for those who are without family.
God of healing, we pray for those who have been infected and for their family members. Give them the courage to face this moment of illness. We pray for those healthcare workers managing this epidemic, for scientists who are working hard on a cure in a short time. Give them all strength and vision to face and try and stop this epidemic.
God of love, we pray too for those suffering other illnesses, mental and physical. We pray for people, those who care has been suspended and who fear the future. We pray for those helping, supporting, caring and loving.
God of mercy, allow us to live this time in a profitable opportunity to reflect on our experience of faith. Help us, despite the difficulties of this situation, to keep us united and open to others. Help us not to forget all the other great tragedies that undermine peace and disrupt the world. God of salvation, we pray for you to support us in fighting the chains of exploitation and injustice, and help us to maintain chains of solidarity throughout the world. Please help us as we deal with this fear of contagion, and even more to deal with the contagion of fear. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Let love be real in giving and receiving, without the need to manage and to hold. A haven free from posing and pretending, where every weakness may be safely known. Give me your hand along the desert pathway. Give me your love wherever we may go. As God loves us, so let us love each other, with no demands, just open hands and space to grow. Let love be real, not grasping or confining, that strange embrace that holds yet sets us free, that helps us face the risk of truly living, and makes us brave to be what we might be. Give me your strength when all my words are weakness. Give me your love in spite of all you know. As God loves us, so let us love each other, with no demands, just open hands and space to grow.
let love be real with no manipulation, no secret wish to harness or control. Let us accept each other's incompleteness and share the joy of learning to be whole. Give me your hope through dreams and disappointments. Give me your trust when all my failings show. As God loves us, so let us love each other with no demands, just open hands and space to grow.
Right, in your own time.
So, just a few words before we share our blessing. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there's injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there's darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. And maybe you'd like to join with me as we say the blessing. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and evermore. Amen. Thank you for taking part in the service, whether that's an active part or just watching and joining in. And I hope it's not too long until we can be back together. Because I love you and miss you all.